All right. So today I'll show you my hat there. I made it with the technique of the crochet. And it's a hat for armor also. You can use it underneath the armor if you have the armor. But it's for the wind and for the hot sunshine. And it goes so low. It goes so low there. You see it goes all the way back. That when you're out in the hot sun, that it takes away the wind from the aggression on you, and it takes away also the hot sun, so you don't end up with a red neck, anything so stupid. So there it goes, and it was easy. You start at the top, you make the circle, and you just keep going around and around, and then scrunch it together, and then I made like these little pulley things. It feels a retard at first to do it, but in the beginning, I'm like, well, I have to sleep at night, you know, and so I put the hair in the twist up high, and then tighten it up there, and it stays all the night, and so I can be almost in Arctic with this wear on the head. So it's a pretty good one, huh? Yeah. So it's a little bit of that, the gear, the gear of where, the gear of where. Oh my gosh, yeah, I changed the room, didn't I? I got the battery for the computer, it's happy now. It sparked out to zero. And when it sparks out to zero like that, I had to get a brand new. Oh my gosh. Yeah, so I'm happy with this hat. So anyway, but what was I really going to talk about? I want to talk about Flickr, actually. I want to talk about Flickr, the program that gives you the terabyte for free. I don't want to be the advertisement for Flickr. I'll try to change this, the brightness is awful. I don't want to be the advertisement for hey, they're the great 1 terabyte, because, wow. They're not. They're not a great 1 terabyte. There are many things missing, but we have to help them in a way, because they've done so far, you know. And so instead of being aggressive towards it's not working, it's not a file handler system that we prefer. It's not hey, right now there's my files. Why don't you just copy my files the same as my files are into your files? You know, why isn't it just a simple file to file change? Oh. No, it's not. It's the same organization, except they gave the hierarchy the name collection, and the lower files the name of sets. And so then, oddly, you can make collections from your various sets, and change who goes into. So you can have the collections, mini collections, and yet they share the same set. So you can have a collection of this is your trip to Italy, and then you can have a collection only of Italian flowers, and so you can have that one set share. So it's just a file folder name called set now. So file folder now equals set, and the higher of the file folder equals a name called collection, and underneath collection you can keep collections, and underneath sets underneath collections you can keep more and more of those. No, this is not a good video, is it? It's terrible. Well, I'll try it with this. I had the better camera on earlier, but the computer went belly up on it. Oh my gosh. Well, anyway, so yay. And so I'm having problems there also. It has the tags. Now I put the tags there. It has for you know, explain what is in there, what is in each particular group set. And so you can, when you upload the whole set at once, it's the moment to remember to put the tags. It's right there at that moment. Because the batch edit is not really a batch edit. The batch edit is a pretend, like, hey, look at each one, see, in its own place. Look at each one and go, that is not a batch edit. Immediately, it's not a batch edit. It's nothing beautiful of that ilk. It is showing you file for file for file, and each one has to be individually updated. And so it's not a hey, give me all of the same particulars that I had when I originally uploaded the set. Those choices are not available any longer as a group. So that is the weirdness. And so now you're like, well, maybe I just have to take them all away and upload them again with the new words, you know? Because if you want to change the tags ever, you cannot change the tags. No, you cannot at this point in time change the tags. You can only add new tags. And then they have a recommended feature that is automatic. It's automatic that anybody that you have as your followers or your friends or your persons that are in your affiliates with the Flickr, that they can add tags to your tags. So all of these persons are adding tags, but not one way to change the original tags given. So unless you go to the batch edit or each photo independently, and the batch edit is simply the interface of a file here with words, each one shown, but it's not for the entire group all at once. So each one, so if you have 70 photos, it means each one has to be done at a time. So it's not a batch edit. It is look at the batch, sort of. So that's a big correction they have to fix. Somehow make it kind of the same, similar as when you uploaded it in the original. I know, it's free service, so I complain, everyone, free service. I know. Don't complain from the free. Yeah. Oh my gosh, what else I have to say about Flickr? There's a lot of other things, a lot of other things that, when it says the info, this is confusant. It has all of these copyright places, copyright here, copyright there, this way or that way. This word called attribution. Does anybody know what attribution means? Oh my gosh, I have to look it up on the dictionary. I'm not an attribution specialist in that word and define, so no, I'm sorry, I flunked out attribution. So yet, I still take it though, I still put attribution in there, and I'm not really sure if that was the correct way to go. My foot is falling asleep. So there, with attribution, then they have all of these different variations. So it gets exciting. In the immediacy of the upload and you realize where the set is, it gets oddly exciting because you can make these different agreements. This is edit this way and this is edit that way. And so I'm like, okay, great. That's fabulous. However, later on, I did not put the word info, which means kind of like the splattering across the top of the screen, I think, forever. Include this, and so it kind of ruins the photo. And so it's not a mouse over that shows you the info. That would be beautiful, to have a mouse over, and then it shows the info of the photo. Like, it is not available for you to grab and take and use in commercial, unless you pay the person. And I'm not seeing this service, unless you pay the person. Where is this service? It just says, you can't have it? No, you can have the photo, but you have to pay the person. And so this doesn't seem to be available there. And that is an odd one. I'm not understanding that, why there isn't, you can have the photo commercial, but you have to pay the person. It's very simple. So where is that one? I didn't see it. There's also, yeah, because I have to block everyone. No, you can't use it, you can't have it for the commercial, you can't have it, you can't have it, you can't have it, you can't rework it, you can't use it in any derivative works, you know, works of it derived, even take a half or a part of it and do something with it. And that's kind of a halting, isn't it? It's kind of a halting, a stop. And that's a mean. I didn't really want that type of a mean to be going on, you know. So what was I doing there? So the info there, I made all these selections with the info, and this is all concerning the copyright. Don't take my photo, don't take the photo of my works and make them commercial, because it's very simple to put my dog there, out on top of your Purina dog chow. It's very simple, and I don't want this, and I do not want this at all. So the info is there, and I'm like, now what am I gonna do? Because I did not click the info. So the photo is there exposed and it's ready for everyone to just take, and what? It is somewhere where? It's not in the X if I can't find where this info is. So because there's no mouse over, there's no like immediacy of seeing, the person holding it is grabbing it, and they have no concept of whatever the copyright was, written attribution or whatever. So there's not that agreement of what even this edit for the copyright was. So it's another snag halting again of the person's what? Why does it have to be like that, you know? So that's my big problem with it. I was with a photo bucket, but then I don't have the iPhone, I don't have the Android, and so I could not get the additional 8 gigabytes. But the photo bucket is easy. The photo bucket is, but you still have to. They not take all the folders either. Nobody's taking all the take the main folder and clicking all the subfolders. Nobody's taking that direction that way because that's so easy. I have hundreds and hundreds of seems like it. No, I have thousands of photos, but then. It seems like I have hundreds of files, but no, maybe not hundreds. But it seems like that would be you take the hierarchical one and go zong to zong zong, you know, all the way down, like that. You know, if animals, then you go animals, the birds, the dogs, to fish, the cats, whatever. You know what I'm saying? And then underneath the fish, the cats, they have theirs, and so all of the subdirectories are normal and on your personal PC version. So it's not this direction. They did not go this direction, either one of them. So you have to do type each one in and recreate it. Recreate it, and yet at the same time you're recreating with the Flickr, you have to go away with the words file. You're not using file anymore, using the word set. And because you're using the word set, then you have to thusly go to the hierarchical with the word collection. And I'm not sure how a person's even find the word collections in the particulars. I hate these tech videos. This is like, here is like my technical helper video for Flickr now. Are you paying me, Flickr? Are you paying me? I know it. We were so helpful out here, aren't we? So anyway, so what else is Flickr doing? Oh my gosh. It's okay, except for now. There's the main zoom mouse over wave wand. I want to take this. There is the beautiful photo you have there, the best size, whatever, but I want to zoom into it, you know, right away. I want to just go make it bigger, you know, this also. Can you make the photo, you know, extrapolate? And I'm not getting that action from it. It's not getting that at all. It's just staying, and it's a certain size. And if you click on the photo, well, it's not helping. It goes to the next photo. I believe it goes to the next photo. It could go to the edit page, or edit possibility page, but I'm pretty sure it is going to. I'm pretty sure it's going not to the zoom. No, it's never going to a zoomer of the original size. And so even though it's saying that you are uploading the original size, and it's keeping everything in its original size in place, it's very much like, uh-oh. You have to go to the settings for that to have it listed as an original size. So it makes the layout a little bizarre that they didn't give you the zoom option. So that would be something that would be good as an upgrade, to give the zoom option just on site of whatever is in this photo stream thing, they call it. The photo stream is anything, you know, anything that just shows up. All of a sudden you put an image out there. And if you have a set already, you still have, it is not a memory for the set. This is an obnoxious. When you have five photos, let's say you have a set that has 75 photos, you have five photos new that you're adding. So you have the birds, you're adding five new to the birds a set. Now, the five photos are not available with the free give knowledge that this set has these tags. No, you're not able to claim those tags. So you have to rewrite the tags again, and then it goes to the set. So here it is, there are the names there, rewrite the tags, and then you put them into the set. So the set, by the choice of choosing that set of birds, when you choose birds, you're not getting the information. So I'm not getting the information claim of the copyright. I have to redo this. I'm not getting the information of whatever goes into that set of the tags. So it is not keeping a history of the set for the new photos that have chosen that set. So that is a big error. Yeah. So my goodness. It's a work, isn't it? It's a big work. I would definitely think that would be an upgrade, just to have that mimic immediately. I'm choosing the set, so you just take all that data that is normally there, that is the main historical for the tags, the main history. All of them are containing that. Do you want this? You know, do you want those tags? If you have to say yes, you know, go ahead and do that. But that would be a wonderful addition, just to add the tags that were previously there. And then also add the copyright information also. So what do I do now if it's not this wave over info? I'm not sure. So now I've put out a thousand of them. I guess I can go back and then put those little ugly, like, I don't know, those little ugly icons on the image. I mean, what a ruin. I don't know. What a ruin. I just didn't want to go that way. That's all. I don't know. Is my hat a happy? Is my hat a happy hat? I don't know. It's a survivor hat, I guess so. In this dune environment here. They lumbered down some pretty heavy trees recently. I'm not too happy about it. They're massive, massive trees, and I'm heartsick struck. What do you do? I'm not taking photo of it any longer, because what am I? I'm like the show and tell. This is how you lumber a tree, the bigger the size, you know? I'm not showing a photo of it. It's too gross. It's just too gross what they did. You know, come on. It's massive trees. Come on. We don't have that many massive trees. What the heck? It was almost like the order was to take the biggest trees in the region, you know, just take the biggest trees and get the hell out. Is that the order? Is that the order where I live? I don't know. Just wants me to go out of this life, you know. This is my epitaph. Jerks. They're all jerks. That's all you all want.